This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is example 30 of solving equations with fractions. And in this problem, we've got four different fractions you see here, and we also have a parenthesis, so we've got the distributive property. So there's going to be more than one way to solve this. So let's do it first by doing the distributive property first. So we have 1/16 plus x over 8. Nothing to do on the left side, but on the right side we need to distribute. So we have 3/8 times x. And if you want, you could write that as 3x over 8. It's up to you. Minus, all right, can we do this on our head? 3/8 times 1/2. You'd multiply the denominators, which is 3/16. So we've done the distributive property, and a lot of times people like doing the distributive property first if the numbers aren't too big, especially because it's a little less confusing when you multiply by the least common denominator. So now we look at this and decide what the least common denominator is. All right, so we've got 16, 8, 8, 16. 16 is the least common denominator. So what we're going to do is multiply both sides of the equation by, 16. So we have 16 times 1/16 plus 16 times x over 8 equals 16 times 3/8 x minus 16 times 3/16. And you might not need to write this step out. I do it so everybody could see what's going on. Those cancel. It cancels to 2. It cancels to 2. And these cancel completely. So remember, there's still 1 here. Don't forget that term here. And if you want, you could put 1s when it cancels completely. There we go. All right, so what do we have? 1, that's the first term, plus 2x equals, well, I've got 2 times 3 times x, 6x, minus 3. So we did the distributive property, then we multiplied by the least common denominator, and now we have an equation without fractions or parentheses. So now we have to solve this. You can put the variables on the right or the left. I'm going to put them on the right, which makes them positive in front of the variable. So negative 2x means I'll get 4x on that side, right? And so since I'm gonna have the x's on this side, I wanna get rid of the plus 3 to both sides. I wanna get rid of the negative 3 by adding 3 to both sides. That'll be 4. Check this one out. Divide both sides by 4, and you get x equals 1. So we got x equals 1. Wow, this big messy thing, 1 is the answer. Who would have known? All right, let's try it by multiplying by the least common denominator first, for those of you who'd like to see what that looks like, and then we'll check it. All right, so here was the problem. Instead of distributing first, I think in this case that was probably easier, but we can just multiply everything by the least common denominator. And you see a 6, an 8, an 8, a 2, so the least common denominator is going to be 16. We'll start with that. So we have 16 times 1/16 plus 16 times x over 8 equals 16 times 3/8 x minus 1/2. So these cancel. The 8 goes into the 16 twice. Now, you got to be careful here. You do not distribute the 16. You're first doing 16 times 3/8, and then whatever that answer is gets multiplied by the x minus 1/2. That's the disadvantage of doing this first, is some people accidentally also multiply what's in parentheses by 16. It's a danger to watch out for. So it's 2 times 3, right? So what do we have? We've got 1 plus plus 2x equals 6 times x minus 1 half. Now notice that this, I didn't get rid of the 1 half inside the parentheses. First I was just dealing with the rest of these. But if you do your distributive property now, you end up not having a fraction. If that wouldn't happen, then I guess you would deal with that at the next step. So we have 6x, 1 plus 2x equals 6x minus, well, 6 times a half, that's half a 6, which is 3. And it's exactly the same as before. Subtract 6x. So we have negative 4x on this side. So you also want to subtract 1, so the constants are on the other side, gives you a negative 4, and then divide by negative 4. So x equals 1. After doing a couple of these problems, I think I'm going to suggest that you do the distributive property first, unless the numbers are just really huge, you might want to try this. But that would be my suggestion, but I do like to show that it can be done either way. So let's check our answer. We got x is 1. So we have to plug in 1 for x and do the order of operations on each side. So we're going to plug in 1 for x. And we need to get a common denominator to add 1 16th plus 1 8th. So we can multiply by 2 over 2. So we have 1 16th plus 2 16ths is 3 16ths. Okay, let's do the other side. Now remember, we're doing the order of operation, and there is no distributive property when you have numbers. You just simplify inside the parentheses first. So I'm going to put in 1 for x. Do 1 minus 1 half. I imagine most of you could do 1 minus 1 half without changing that to a common denominator, so I'm going to make that assumption that you know that 1 minus 1 half is the same thing as 1 half. And then multiplying across, we get 3 16ths, and we're done. So that means that x equals 1 is the correct answer, right? X equals 1 is the right answer. And putting it in solution, as a solution set in braces, it looks like this. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.